Full-time energy drink advertisement and professional football club RB Leipzig are the most hated team in the German game. Unlike here in the Premier League, the Bundesliga has largely managed to resist many of the trappings of modern football when it comes to ludicrous ticket prices, a sanitised matchday experience, and a huge disconnect between the owners, the players, and the fans. That is a very broad generalisation, and of course the Bundesliga is not immune to commercialisation, and the Premier League is not entirely lacking in heart or soul. But broadly speaking, there is undoubtedly a gulf between the two. There is one major exception to that rule, and that is of course RB Leipzig. The product of a 3.5 year search for a suitable location for a German club by Red Bull company and their Austrian owner Dietrich Mateschitz, the billionaire businessman eventually settled upon Leipzig, reportedly paying €350,000 to acquire the playing rights of local fifth tier outfit SSV Markenstadt. The Red Bull company stripped Markenstadt of their identity, renamed them Rasenballsport Leipzig because DFB rules prevent corporate titles from club names, and set about on a spending spree. It must be said, RB Leipzig have been superbly managed in terms of their recruitment and development of facilities. It is just a shame that they exist only to facilitate the promotion of an energy drink. In the space of 11 years, Leipzig have gone from the German 5th tier to Bundesliga title challengers and Champions League semi-finalists. A big thank you to Brighton and England amputee footballer Ben, who sent in this idea on Instagram, along with the suggestion of similar videos for both Sevilla and Atalanta. I'll see how this video does first before committing to those two, but today's video is a look at everyone who featured for RB Leipzig in their 2-1 win against Atletico Madrid in the Champions League quarterfinal, and where they were 7 years ago. And if there's a bit of time left over at the end, I might do a quick skim through the rest of the squad. Okay, here we go then. Peter Galaxy. RB Salzburg. Peter Galaxy played a little bit like I remember him from his time at Hull City during RB Leipzig's 3-0 defeat to PSG in the Champions League semi-finals, but by and large, he has been superb for the young East German club. Hull City were one of three English clubs that Galaxy joined on loan during his time at Liverpool, and it was actually 7 years ago this summer that he left the Reds in a move to RB Salzburg. There, Galaxy made 100 appearances in just 2 seasons, becoming a Hungarian international and earning a move to Red Bull's strongest footballing franchise in Leipzig. Leipzig were in the second Bundesliga when Galaxy arrived, but they're powerhouses of the German game now, and the 30-year-old has been one of the best goalkeepers in Germany over the last few seasons. Lukas Klostermann, VfL Bochum. As with the number of players in the RB Leipzig squad, given that they have a fairly young squad, Lukas Klostermann was actually yet to make his first team debut 7 years ago. The 24-year-old was already a Germany under-17 international though, coming up through the youth ranks at VfL Bochum. Klostermann broke into the second Bundesliga side's first team in 2014, aged 18, but only had time to make 9 appearances before catching the eye of RB Leipzig. They paid less than €1 million to acquire the teenager, who has since become one of the best right-backs in the Bundesliga, and a full German international in what now looks to have been a fine piece of business. Dayo Upamecano, Valenciennes. Although he has been around for a little while now, Dayo Upamecano is still extremely young for a centre-back, aged only 21. The Normandy native joined Ligue 1 side Valenciennes on youth forms in 2013, aged 14. Following 2 years in the club's academy, he headed to Liefering in Austria, becoming a first-team regular at the age of 16. Less than 12 months later, he was signed by Liefering's parent club, RB Salzburg, for just over €2 million, and within a year, he was on the move once again, this time to sister club RB Leipzig for €10 million. Upamecano has proved to be a bargain for both Red Bull franchises. He's now one of the most highly regarded young centre-backs in world football, and he just received his first senior call-up from the French national team. Marcel Halstenberg, St. Pauli. One of RB Leipzig's slightly more experienced heads, albeit still only 28, Marcel Halstenberg was playing senior football 7 years ago. A graduate of the Hanover youth ranks, Halstenberg never actually played a first team game for his boyhood club and was subsequently signed by Borussia Dortmund too. It was exactly 7 years ago that he was signed by St. Pauli, where he got his first taste of first team rather than reserve team football. Another excellent signing by Leipzig, they snapped Halstenberg up in 2015 for a reported €3 million, as the left-back swapped perhaps Germany's most community-led club for the nation's most commercial. 5 years on, Halstenberg has played over 150 games at the Red Bull Arena, and he too is a full German international. Konrad Leimer, Liefering. There are a number of Austrians in the RB Leipzig squad, as there have been throughout their ascent through the German footballing pyramid, and that should come as little surprise given their obviously very close ties with RB Salzburg. Konrad Leimer followed a very similar route to Dayo Upamecano, going from Liefering to RB Salzburg, and then from RB Salzburg onto RB Leipzig. 7 years ago, Leimer was just 16, and he was yet to make his first team debut for Liefering, but he was already impressing in Austria's youth ranks. He has now won 7 caps for Austria's senior team, as well as making 40 plus appearances for Leipzig in each of the last 2 seasons. Kevin Campbell, RB Salzburg. One of the few players in this RB Leipzig squad who was actually pretty well known 7 years ago, Kevin Campbell, had caught the eye in his first season at RB Salzburg. It was his second season and in his third season that he really got tongues wagging though, as Campbell emerged as one of Europe's rising young stars and he was snapped up by Borussia Dortmund for €12 million in January 2015. Unlike most youngsters who signed for Dortmund, things didn't work out for Campbell, and within just 6 months, he was offloaded to his former club Bayer Leverkusen. Campbell's move to RB Leipzig came in the summer of 2017 for what was then a club record fee and what remains the second or third highest fee they have ever spent of €20 million. Angelino, Manchester City. A man who featured not so long ago in my video taking a look at 7 times teams activated buyback clauses 7 years ago, Angelino was still in his first stint with Manchester City. The attack-minded fullback come wingback was just an academy player 7 years ago, aged only 16, and he had just left the Deportivo La Coruña youth ranks to link up with the City Football Academy. Angelino made 3 appearances in 3 seasons with the Citizens, going out on loan 4 times before leaving permanently for PSV. Just 1 good season in the Eredivisie was all it took for Man City to activate the Spaniard's release clause, although it would seem they did so solely for financial reasons, with Angelino reportedly set to sign for RB Leipzig on a permanent deal this summer. Marcel Sabitzer, Rapid Vienna. Another Austrian, oddly enough, Marcel Sabitzer didn't join RB Leipzig from RB Salzburg, although he has now played for both clubs. Sabitzer was starring for Rapid Vienna 7 years ago, having joined Austria's most successful club from Admira Wacker in January 2013. Following 18 months in Vienna, Sabitzer was signed by Leipzig whilst the club was still in the second Bundesliga. As mentioned, he has played for 2 Red Bull franchises since he spent his first season contracted to Leipzig on loan with Salzburg, but he has been a regular fixture for Leipzig since the summer of 2015. Dani Olmo, Barcelona. Subscribers to this channel will know that I am very rarely right about anything, but I did say a little while back that I thought Dani Olmo could cut it at the highest level, and he now has that chance with RB Leipzig. 7 years ago, Olmo was entering his final season in Barcelona's La Masia youth ranks. One that got away from a Barca perspective perhaps, they had poached the talented wide man or attacking midfielder from local rivals Espanyol when he was only 9 years old, but Olmo left in a surprise move to Dinamo Zagreb at 16 in the hope of increased first team opportunities. He got his wish and took his chance, becoming one of the most exciting prospects outside of Europe's top 5 leagues. Olmo signed for Leipzig in a deal worth more than €20 million in January of this year, and he scored the game's opener as Leipzig knocked Atletico Madrid out of the Champions League. Christopher Nkunku, PSG. With the amount of money they have spent over the last 10 years, PSG have had to let go of some real talent for the simple reason that they were unable to meet their demands in terms of game time. Christopher Nkunku spent 9 years with the Champions League finalists, including 4 in the first team, during which time he registered 78 appearances. Versatile, hard-working and good on the ball, Nkunku is at his happiest playing through the middle, but he's equally capable of playing on either wing when asked to do so. Aged 22, 7 years ago, Nkunku was still in the PSG academy, and he joined Leipzig from the Parisians for a potential €15 million last summer. Yusuf Poulsen, RB Leipzig. RB Leipzig's all-time record appearance holder, despite the fact he is still only 26, it was in the summer of 2013 that Poulsen signed for the newly founded club, which was only 4 years old at the time. Poulsen was very highly rated following his form for Denmark's under-19s in particular, and there was no shortage of interest in him. His arrival in Leipzig, at a time when the East German outfit was still in the 3rd Liga then, was seen as a real statement of intent. Poulsen played a key role in 2 promotions for the Red Bull franchise, and he remains an important figure at the Red Bull Arena now. In total, Poulsen has made 251 appearances for the club, during which time he has scored 63 goals. Amadou Haidara, JMG Academy Bamako. I'm not actually sure about this one, since I don't know when Amadou Haidara joined JMJ Academy Bamako, and whether it was before or after the summer of 2013, so he was either there or he hadn't yet been picked up by the academy system. The JMG Academy is a group of academies across the world based in France, Belgium, and a number of former French colonies. JMG Academy Bamako, as its name suggests, is based in Bamako, Mali's rapidly expanding capital city, and that is where Amadou Haidara began his footballing education. He went through the full Red Bull system, joining RB Salzburg in 2016, spending a season on loan with their feeder club Liefering before stepping up and making a move to Leipzig. A young midfielder with bags of potential, Haidara wasn't always at his best this season, but with 12 months of Bundesliga football under his belt, don't be surprised to see much improvement next term. Tyler Adams, New York Red Bulls. We ought not forget that Red Bull owns franchises outside of Europe, and Tyler Adams ensures that we cannot forget that fact, since the only two teams he has ever played for have been New York Red Bulls and RB Leipzig. 7 years ago, Adams was just 14, but he'd already been in the Red Bulls Academy for a couple of years. He broke into the first team at 16, emerging as one of the most promising young players in America, and at the age of 19, he was snapped up by RB Leipzig. He has made 29 appearances in his first 18 months in the Bundesliga, and he scored Leipzig's late winner after being introduced from the bench against Atletico Madrid. Patrick Schick, Sparta Prague. Talented Czech international Patrick Schick was just 17 years old 7 years ago, and he was just on the verge of breaking into the first team at Sparta Prague. He made his debut in May 2014, and following some fine form for Czech Republic's under-21s, Schick joined Sampdoria for €4 million. Having impressed in his debut campaign, Schick was signed by Roma in a deal only worth an initial €14 million, but given the unusual way in which the transfer was structured, potentially as much as €42 million if every single add-on was activated. Schick spent last season on loan with RB Leipzig, and despite interest from Leipzig and Newcastle United in striking a permanent deal, the 24-year-old is apparently close to agreeing terms with Bayer Leverkusen. Nordi Mukele, Laval. Another French youth international shrewdly snapped up by RB Leipzig in 2018, Nordi Mukele was also just a youth team player 7 years ago. Born in the suburbs of Paris, Mukele left Paris FC's academy to join Laval's in 2013, and he broke into the Ligue 2 side's first team in 2014. He was signed by Montpellier in January 2017, but after just 18 months on France's south coast, Leipzig came in with a €16 million bid for the pacey and tough-tackling centre-back. He has already played 67 games for Leipzig and is one of a number of excellent young French centre-backs. So that's where every player who featured for RB Leipzig against Atletico Madrid in the Champions League was 7 years ago. In terms of just a few players who didn't feature in that game, Emil Forsberg was starring for Malmo back in 2013, Ademola Lookman had just joined the Charlton Athletic youth ranks from non-league side Waterloo, and recently departed all-time club record goalscorer Timo Werner had just become Stuttgart's youngest ever player by making his debut for the club in the Europa League in early August 2013, aged only 17. One suspects Die Rotten may wish they had never sold Werner to Leipzig for just €10 million, given that the 24-year-old joined Chelsea this summer for £47.5 million. That's all from me for today then, but do not hesitate to hurtle at lightning speed towards the like button if you enjoyed today's video. I'm told that it's good for the algorithm or something like that. As ever, thank you all for watching. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. Feel free to follow me on either Twitter or Instagram at HITC7s, and obviously do make sure that you're subscribed to the Everest of Football YouTube channels. I suppose we're not actually the biggest, so it would be inaccurate to say the Everest of Football YouTube channels, but make sure you're subscribed to the Kirk Uvell of Football YouTube channels then. Not the biggest, but still quite clearly the best and the most beautiful. Shout out to all of our Icelandic subscribers and to all Orophiles out there who know exactly what I'm talking about. And one last fun fact, Everest should really be pronounced Everest, since it's named after British geographer George Everest. And if you learn nothing else from this video, that is at least something.